So let's take a look at how this toolpath is going to function. What we're going to do is use the new unified to reproduce any of the classical toolpaths that we have here. So what you can see is we're using a taper form tool, and we're doing a morph between these two curves with a one-way cut, and we're working from one edge to the other across that flat. Now in unified, we're going to have to build this up a little differently. So what we're going to do is pick our tool. So we have tool number one set, and we're going to go ahead and define everything in the cut pattern page. So we have a few choices: automatic rows, curve rows, surface rows, plane rows, or remove a row. So before we get into anything, we're going to pick what we want to cut on. So we're going to pick our drive surface. That's going to be our face. That's what we want to work across. Now we're going to add a curve row. And you can see we have a couple options. We end up with guide, parallel, perpendicular, or projected. Okay, in our case, we're just going to leave it at guide for right now. And we're going to choose the solid edge across that face to choose our start curve. Now, if I add in a second guide curve, and we're going to go ahead and pick it, so we get our other rail, we get a new option, morph or project. So you have to have two rails to morph between, but as long as you have the two, we get the option to choose morph. All of our other settings in here have already been preset to duplicate the other toolpath, and you can see the motion we're going to get. We have a nice smooth entry motion coming in, slightly different from the original morph, but we applied the entry motion and the exit motion. We get the same one-way type cuts, and we get a nice smooth transition across the part. What sets the unified apart is we can go in and modify and edit that toolpath at any time later on. We can change its style. With the classic toolpaths, you're stuck. Once you choose to do a morph, you get a morph. Now we're looking at parallel. We're going to go ahead and reproduce that same parallel motion across this part. As we go into our toolpath, we're going to choose what we want to do. This time, we're going to add a surface row. We're going to be parallel to a surface. So we're going to go ahead and choose to be parallel to that surface. We can also choose the flow lines of a surface to be parallel to as well. In this case, we want to be parallel to the actual surface. Surface we're going to use is that tiny little ribbon that sets the curvature of that top face. And we're going to choose for our drive, we're going to go to the three sets of surfaces across the top. That's all we need to actually produce this toolpath, minus the other base settings for entry, step over, and everything else. But you can see we take the curvature that we have, and it projects it in linear steps all the way up that part.